Yeah, it is, without a doubt, the biggest occasion rugby-wise that I've been involved with. Like I said, rugby-wise, otherwise my wife would have killed me that. But, yeah, without a doubt. You know, the anticipation for this series has been building, obviously, all year. And, you know, I think the fact that it's gone down a decider and each game a kick's, you know, basically decided the game in the last 81st minute just says a lot about how close this series is.
Can you speak of James' leadership over, well, I suppose the past fortnight, considering what he's gone through, has it been a distraction, and how has he conducted himself in front of the group in light of this?
Oh, look, I think it potentially could have been a bigger distraction if he wasn't as mentally tough as he is. It just, you haven't seen it really rattle him at all, and, you know, potentially that could have been a huge problem for a bloke to be facing, you know, that sort of cloud hanging over you for 2 weeks. But you know, yesterday when we got the news through that he'd been cleared for the final time, hopefully, you know, it really, there was a lot of man hugging and back slapping going on, and I think that just showed, it brought the group together, but it just showed how important he is to us as a side, not only as our captain, because he's a great leader, but probably one of the premier second rowers in the world at the moment. And going into a side, you need those types of guys on the field.
However, considering how strong the unit was in the last 15 minutes of that game in Melbourne, was there a belief now in the side that even without James that you could get the job done on Saturday night?
Look, there's a huge belief within this side that we can get the result, you know, in whatever circumstances we have to come across. But I think the way that James led in that last 15 minutes, the decision he made at the 72nd minute mark to take the scrum that eventually led to you know, the 7 points that got us a result, you know, they're tough decisions.
How many people do you think would have done that?
I'm not too sure, but I'm just glad that he made that decision, and you know, very fortunate that we've got guys like Adam Ash and Christian in the back line that can, you know, give you those types of results. So I think it was most of the work was done 1-8 in the scrum anyway, but you know, they get all the good reports for it.